Setting off over our green and pleasant land, it's pretty hard to imagine on a sunny day like this just how much this winter has changed the face and shape of the United Kingdom forever. The incessant storms, the heavy rains have brought extreme flooding and misery to many. Whole swathes of the country have been submerged. And even though the floods may now be receding, the nightmare continues for thousands.
Britain really is an island nation. We've got some 11,000 miles of coastline, some stunning sights along the way. That is more coastline than India or Brazil, believe it or not. But over the last few weeks, it has taken a real battering and beating. It's been eroded and gouged away. In fact, the National Trust says that they've seen 7 years of erosion in some parts of the coastline in just 2 weeks.
And flying over the Dorset coast, it's clear there's been a dramatic change in the shoreline.
The National Trust has had a long history of managing the coast, as you've suggested, so we've learnt what not to do and what to do. And although there were some hard defences at Studland in the 80s, we're now working to work with natural processes and remove some of those defences, because we've learned that the best way of protecting the beach and ensuring that there is a beach at Studland into the long term is to actually allow it to naturally migrate landwards. And if you try and hold back sand in one location, it will actually cause more erosion further up the coast.
Continuing my journey away from the country's coast, we head to Tewkesbury. Here, the issue is of construction, and building new homes is a hot topic. Hundreds of homes have planning permission to be built on floodplains. 570 homes have been given the go-ahead on land between Tewkesbury and Gloucester, land that's been underwater for the last few weeks. The plans need rethinking, says the local MP and many of the local residents.
Well, I don't think we learned the lessons fully from 2007, which was that don't build too many houses in areas which flood or close to areas which flood. Look, it's very easy to build new houses that they themselves won't flood. But the trouble is they press the water, they push the water onto other areas, causing them to flood. And that is the difficulty.
Back in the helicopter and flying east towards the Thames estuary. Here, more than £100 million was spent trying to tame the river.
The Jubilee River Flood Control and Relief Channel is one of the biggest engineering projects ever undertaken in this country. A 7-mile channel that diverts the Thames water away from towns like Maidenhead, Eton and Windsor. But some critics of the scheme say that it merely shifts the problem elsewhere, to towns like Datchet, where the Thames meets up with the Jubilee River again.
You feel that the Jubilee River, which saves a lot of people's properties downstream, is not doing you a lot of favours here?
Not at all. The £110 million was public money, and it's been spent on one small section of the river on the basis of cost-benefit analysis. But this thing never carried its design capacity. It is incapable of carrying its design capacity.
So, are these wild winters going to be the norm in future? Not even scientists seem to know the answer. You can be sure, though, that the outlook will be unpredictable. So we'd better be prepared. And like protecting Britain against the threat of terrorism, the experts warn that our flood defences will never be perfect.